We want to calculate the pH of a 2/10 molar solution of acetic acid, and we're given Ka as 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5, and then we're given the reaction where acetic acid partially dissociates. And so what we do, we're starting out molar, and then we have some dissociation, unless, say, X, and we're not going to worry about the water since the water concentration is so high in this calculation, its change is insignificant. And Ka is equal to hydronium ion concentration, the acetate ion concentration over the acetic acid concentration. And all of these are molar, so this is equal to 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5, and different books do this different ways, but strictly speaking, this would have units of molar for this to be consistent. This then becomes x squared over 0.20 minus x, and then we'll make the normal assumption that x is small relative to 0.2. So this means x squared is 0.2 times 1.8 times 10 to the minus 5, which is 3.6 times 10 to the minus 6. And so therefore, x is equal to 1.90 times 10 to the minus 3. And so we can see it's a good assumption that x is only about 1% of 0.2. And so therefore, H3O concentration 1.9 times 10 to the minus 3. Well, we want the pH. So the pH is minus the log base 10 of H3O plus concentration. So minus the log of 1.9 10 to the minus 3. Remember, this is molar units, and we need to use molar units here. And so therefore, the pH is 2.7 for this acetic acid solution.